We've seen lots of comments about the 120 ancestors that I keep on mentioning. Where is this coming from? And how are we only related to 120 people? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is an episode of a segment of DNA. So today I want to talk about the 120 genetic ancestors that we have in any given generation. I've explained this in a couple of different videos before, but I'm going to go into a little bit more detail and try to make this so that you can understand where I'm coming from and what I mean by that. So when we're thinking of genealogy, we know that we have parents and grandparents and great-grandparents, and we're related to all of them. And it doesn't matter how far back we go, it doesn't matter how many generations, we're still related to everybody because each set of parents had a child. And that child grew up, married somebody, and they had more children, and on down the generations. But then when we add genetics into it, we're not always related to all those people genetically. Now, we are still related to them from a genealogical standpoint, but we don't necessarily get all of our DNA from all of those different people. We only get it from a small subset of those people. Now, what do I mean by this? Let's start with our entire bit of DNA. It is about 3 billion letters long. So we have a limit already. We could not be genetically related to more than 3 billion people in any generation because there's no more DNA than that. Now, 3 billion is a lot. It actually wasn't until very recently, in the last 100 years, that there was even 3 billion people on Earth. Now, when you're talking about genealogy, when you think of two parents and four grandparents and on back, how far back do you need to go to get to 3 billion? Surprisingly, you only need to go back to about 1200 AD, and that's about your 30th great-grandparents. In other words, you have 3 billion 30th great-grandparents. Actually, it's about 4.2 billion. But we'll just round down to 3 billion to make it match up with our DNA. So you have 3 billion 30th great-grandparents. A lot of those are the same. But did you receive DNA from each and every single one of them? Well, with humans, at least 99.5% of our DNA is the exact same. In other words, there's no way to distinguish where 99.5% of that DNA came from, because everybody has the exact same. So we can take that 3 billion and take away 99.5% of it and just look at that limit. So this is our second limit then. And this is gonna be about the 10 million SNPs, SNPs, single nucleotide polymorphisms. You don't have to try to remember that. Just remember SNPs. What a SNP is it is a place on your DNA that could be different from somebody else. And if you'll notice, 10 million is about 0.3% of our DNA. So it falls within this 99.5% being the same, that 0.5% that's being different. So these are the 10 million spots so far that we've found that DNA is different. So that's what we could actually tell are from different people. So we could distinguish about 10 million different ancestors. But are we getting our DNA from each of those 10 million? How far back do we have to go to get to 10 million? Well, at 3 billion, I told you we had to only go back to 1200 AD. 10 million, we only have to go back to 1400 AD, only about 600 years ago. And that's our 21st great-grandparents. So at that point, you have 10 million people that you're related to in that line. And if you think about yourself, if you are from Europe, in 1400 AD, there was about 50 million people in Europe. So if you were related to 10 million of them, you could really honestly be related to 10 million distinct individuals from that time period. But did you get DNA from all of them? Well, let's go to the next limit. Because DNA has a functional limit. For instance, we have 25,000 genes. Now, a gene codes for a certain attribute, and you can't divide a gene up and mix it with something else. DNA doesn't divide like that. So we could look at genes as an upper limit as far as how many people you could be related to. In other words, if you got every single one of your 25,000 genes from a different relative in a certain generation, where would that limit be? Well, if you go back to about 1600 AD, you have 25,000 13th great-grandparents, or thereabouts. So theoretically, you could be related to every single one of those 13 great-grandparents. But that's a whole lot less than the 10 million 21st great-grandparents, or the 3 billion 30th great-grandparents. So are we done yet? Could you inherit your genes from 25,000 different people? Well, theoretically you could. But as we've studied DNA more, what we found is that when the DNA in our autosomal DNA recombines, when it switches places with a corresponding chromosome, it recombines usually at certain spots. These are called hotspots. And the probability of that happening is much greater in these hotspots than anywhere else. Now, with a large enough group of people, it could happen in almost anywhere along the genome, but these hotspots have hundreds of times greater probability. So for instance, for every 400 or 500 people that it's happening in point A, there may be one person where that swap is happening around point B. So even though we don't know exactly where it's going to happen each time, we have a good guess of the most likely spots it's going to happen. And as you take that information and you run some computer modeling of this, what you end up with is that people only get their DNA from about 120 of their ancestors in any given generation. Now, are we going to see that somewhere? Well, right now, I've had my children tested, I've been tested, my parents have been tested, my grandparents have been tested. That's four generations. We need to go back about eight generations to see that there's some drop-off where we have more than 120 ancestors in that group. And so in another three or four generations, so within another 100 years, the testing companies for DNA are going to have all the data that's going to show how many people you're really getting your DNA from. But right now it's all pointing to only about 120 ancestors. And that's the difference between being genetically related and being genealogically related. We're still related to that 25,000 people in the 1600s. We're still related to that 10 million people back in the 1400s. And even if there was 3 billion people in 1200, we'd still be genealogically related to them. They are our ancestors. But what makes up our DNA is a much smaller set of that. It's only 120 people. And that's pretty amazing. If you have any questions about this, if I haven't explained it enough, put a comment down below and we'll try to explain it again so you understand that you're genetically related to only 120 people. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so that it can reach more viewers. Don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss another episode of Family History Fanatics.